Good morning, and welcome to Gilead Lutheran Church, our online service, which will be available later this afternoon. But if you're watching this on YouTube or whatever, it's on right now. I am Deacon Jim Netzer. I am the associate here at Gilead Lutheran Church, inviting you to join in our service of celebration for the Feast of Pentecost. Helping out today, of course, on harp, like we just heard, and as well as organ, is Jane Dozwa. Also reading today will be Leonard Platt. And we have a number of vocalists this morning. Leonard will be joined by Tanis Krieger, as well as Andrew Kiefer, all singing. I'll even try myself, but who knows how that will turn out. As far as announcements, I would say check with the website, GileadLutheranChurch.org, for things that are coming up. Might have some exciting news for June, but I don't want to let it out of the bag just yet until it all comes into place. So with that little tease, let's just take a moment and gather ourselves in a worshipful mood. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you. And for his sake, God forgives you of all your sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become children of God and bestows on them the Holy Spirit. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share our sign of peace with one another, by who is with us in our homes this afternoon, or those in our thoughts as well. Our entrance in this morning is number 164 of the Lutheran Book of Worship, Creator Spirit, by whose aid.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, on this day you open the hearts of your faithful people by sending into us your Holy Spirit. Direct us by the light of that Spirit, that we may have a right judgment in all things, and rejoice at all times in your peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Pentecost was a Jewish harvest festival that marked the 50th day after Passover. Luke portrays the Holy Spirit being poured out upon the disciples before the gathered and astonished people assembled in Jerusalem for the festival. Filled with the Spirit, the disciples were able to witness to the power of Christ's resurrection. Luke writes, "When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place, and suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, 'Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus, and Asia, Phrygia, and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea, and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my Spirit on all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my Spirit, and they will prophesy. And I will show portents in the heavens above, and signs in the earth below, blood and fire and smoking mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." Here ends the lesson. The psalm is Psalm 104, found in the LBW, page 265. And we will read it responsively by whole verse. O Lord, how manifold are your works! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Yonder is the great and wide sea, with its living things too many to number, creatures both small and great.
There move the ships, and there is that leviathan which you have made for the sport of it.
All of them look to you, to give them food in due season.
You give it to them, they gather. You open your hand, and they are filled with good things.
You hide your face, and they are terrified. You take away their breath, and they die and return to their dust.
You send forth your Spirit, and they are created, and so you renew the face of the earth.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in all his works.
He looks at the earth and it trembles. He touches the mountains and they smoke.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God while I have my being.
May these words of mine please him. I will rejoice in the Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Hallelujah.
Paul is helping the Corinthians understand the relationship between our God-given unity and Spirit-created diversity. The Spirit creates the unity of faith and gives all Christians diverse gifts for the common benefit of all. We need one another's diverse spiritual gifts because the Spirit has been given them for the common good. Paul writes, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit, and there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given a manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the discernment of spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. All of these are activated by one and the same Spirit who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one, has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit. Here ends the lesson.
In our gospel reading this morning, the risen Jesus appears to his disciples, offering them a benediction, a commission, and the gift of the Holy Spirit. It's a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John, the 20th chapter. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After this, he showed them his hands and his side, and the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I sent you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be found pleasing to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Birthdays. It's something we all have. And as a kid, it was always something that we looked forward to. Although my birthday is December 15th. Bad as that may be, my friend Matt had it worse. His birthday was 10 days after mine. But I remember asking my parents if we could move the celebration so that my birthday wouldn't be so close to Christmas. You know, the combining of gifts and things like that. And I said, why not move it to June 15th? It was a humble suggestion on my part. I think they said it was okay, as long as I didn't mind waiting an extra 6 months, which technically meant that I would be, it would be 18 months between my 9th and 10th birthday. Yeah, a definite deal breaker for any kid like that. But for most adults, birthdays are not so subtle reminder that we are getting older. The late 20th century philosopher and humorist George Carlin shared his views on aging. I'd love to share them with you now. And George goes, do you realize in our lives when we like to get old is when we were kids? If you were less than 10 years old, you were so excited about aging that you thought in fractions. How old are you? I'm 4 and a half. You're never 36 and a half. You're 4 and a half going on 5. That was the key. You get into your teens. Now you can't hold back. You jump to the next number or even a couple ahead. How old are you? I'm gonna be 16. Well, you could be 13, but you're gonna be 16. And then the greatest day of your life, you become 21. Even the words sound like a ceremony. You become 21. Yeah. Then you turn 30. Oh, what happened there? Makes you sound like you're bad milk. He turned. We had to throw him out. There's no fun now. You're just a sour dumpling. What's wrong? What's changed? You become 21. You turn 30. Then you're pushing 40. Whoa, put on the brakes. It's all slipping away. Before you know it, you reach 50 and your dreams are gone. But wait, you make it to 60. You didn't think you would. So you become 21, turn 30, push 40, reach 50, and make it to 60. But you built up so much speed that you hit 70. And after that, well, it's just a day-by-day thing. You hit Wednesday. You get into your 80s and every day is a complete cycle. You hit lunch. You turn 4:30 and you reach bedtime. And it doesn't end there. Into the 90s, you start going backwards. I was just 92. Then a strange thing happens. You make it over 100 and you become a little kid again. I'm 100 and a half. May you all make it to a healthy 100 and a half. Well, thank you, George Carlin, for that. I bring up this whole birthday thing because today, of course, is Pentecost Sunday, which marks the church's birthday. I'm not talking about the here where we are, Gilead Lutheran Church in Center Brunswick. I'm not talking about the Hudson Mohawk Conference or the Upstate New York Synod or even the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America. Not even Martin Luther tacking up those 95 theses on a church door in Wittenberg. Indeed, if you think about it, if somebody asked you, what is the church's birthday? You might be confused. You had to think there for a second. Ask some people and they would probably say Christmas. Or others might say Easter. Or if you want a little cheat sheet or something like that, you look at the liturgical calendar and you just might think it was the first Sunday of Advent because that's when the church's new year starts. Pentecost was chosen, though, as the official birthday because, well, let's face it, that's the day that God sent the Holy Spirit to the disciples in a very evocative and, let's face it, not so subtle way. If you recall from our first reading this morning, when the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven, there came a sound like a rush of a violent wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. And divided tongues as a fire appeared among them. And all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them a. Did you just picture all of that in your head? The sound, the sight, everything? And keep in mind, there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at the sound, the crowd was bewildered. What else could you say? Bewildered, because each one of them heard them talking in
their own language. Amazed and astonished, they ask, are these men not all Galileans? How is it that we all hear each of them in our own language? But that line, are not all these who are speaking Galileans, is actually a put down. Because in another part of the Holy Gospel, the question is put forth, what good can come from Galilee? Keep in mind that this same Galilee is featured so prominently through Jesus' ministry. Back then, though, in no uncertain terms, Galileans were considered those ignorant backwater folks. Yet now, those supposed ignorant backwater Galileans are so eloquently sharing the good news of Jesus in a way that everyone, no matter where they came from, can easily understand. But if you think about it, Jesus always did the unexpected, being born in a lowly manger, not a king in some palace, but a helpless little baby in a stable. He broke bread with tax collectors and sinners, performed wondrous signs and miracles, even on the Sabbath. Oh no! And maybe the most confusing part of all, he called ordinary average people to be his apostles. Hardly what anyone would consider saint material. Take Peter, for instance. Jesus told him to be the rock on which he had built his church on. Yet who was it who denied knowing Jesus three times? Yep, good old Pete. Would any of us think that was a wise choice for being the rock of the church? Sure, maybe in 2020 hindsight, since we know how the story ends. Just recall that one verse from today's gospel reading where Jesus said to them, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And those that the good news was declared to, declared it to others, who in turn declared it to even more people. And it continues on, and still continues, today, tomorrow, forever. So my brothers and sisters in Christ, if today is the church's birthday, wouldn't it seem logical that there should be presents given? Need a hint? And all those that the good news was declared to, declared it to others, who in turn declared it to yet more people. And it continued on, and still continues on, today, tomorrow, forever. Remember, he called ordinary, everyday people to be his apostles. Hardly, like I said, what you would consider saint material. Think about it. Aren't we all ordinary, average people too? With your help, along with guidance from the Holy Spirit, remember that through Jesus Christ, all things are possible. And that's one birthday present, which should never be tucked away out of sight, but rather is to be used every day in every way by each one of us. And believe it or not, whether saint or sinner, we are all gifted. I kind of like the way Eugene Peterson put it in this transcription of the from Paul's letter to the Corinthians, which we heard earlier. God's various gifts are handed out everywhere, but they all originate in God's Spirit. God's various ministries are carried out everywhere, but they all originate in God's Spirit. God's various expressions of power are in action everywhere, but God himself is behind it all. Each person is given something to do that shows who God is. Everyone gets in on it, everyone benefits. All kinds of things are being handed out by the Spirit and to all kinds of people. That variety is wonderful. Wise counsel, clear understanding, simple trust, healing the sick, miraculous acts, proclamation, distinguishing between spirits, tongues, and the interpretation of tongues. All these gifts have a common origin, but are handed out one by the one Spirit of God. So what gifts or gifts do you have? And keep in mind that list is not limited to what Paul told the Corinthians. Primarily, the gift from the Holy Spirit will primarily serve to proclaim that Jesus as Lord. And in so doing, it serves the common good as well. That seems kind of simple, right to the point. And during this pandemic, we've heard stories or seen stories of everyday people who've gone out of their way to make life for someone else a little bit better, maybe in some little way. And thankfully, once this pandemic is history, those little things may not no longer be newsworthy, but that's not the important part, because people never did this to be on the news anyway. So just continue to do those little things. Give to a food pantry. Treat others with respect. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Remember Jesus' words, how he said to them, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." Those little things can add up to a lot. We don't think we're all endowed with all these great spirits, but if you are unsure of what you can or should do, or even what gifts you might have, ask. Who do you ask? Ask the Holy Spirit. Now, granted, chances are you won't see divided tongues of fire over your head or the sound like a rush of wind. But that doesn't mean you don't have the gifts to celebrate this church's birthday. Just remember, God works in mysterious ways. You know that. I know that. After all, he chose all of us, no matter who we are, no matter what our birthday is, or even how old we are. God has faith in us. So why not celebrate that faith with others? Sounds like a perfect gift. Amen. Our hymn of the day is number 473 in the Green Book, the Lutheran Book of Worship. Come, Holy Ghost, our souls inspire.
Lord, have mercy.
profess our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God in all times and places in praying for the church, the world, and all who are in need. I will end each petition with, Lord, in your mercy, please respond with, hear our prayer. We call on your spirit of unity, giving thanks for our different vocations. Activate and utilize the diverse gifts present in your church, that they reveal your love for all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We call on your spirit of life, present in air, wind, humidity, storms, and oxygen in our atmosphere, breathing energy into all things. Heal with your breath the whole creation, especially those who struggle to breathe due to air pollution or other lung problems. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We call on your spirit of righteousness. Wherever we as a divided people are, unite us, especially now during these times of troubles in our cities. Wherever we are prideful, humble us. Give each one of us a heart for justice and empathy. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We call on your spirit of healing. Bless nurses, doctors, midwives, chaplains, counselors, and hospice workers, those in need. We pray for all who long for comfort, including those on our prayer list, and especially Nicole Shanahan and her family, as well as those in our thoughts at this moment. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We call on your spirit of friendship. As Elizabeth welcomed Mary into her home, give us a spirit of welcome to those whom we meet, here, there, or wherever we may meet them. Surprise us daily with unexpected grace, that we rejoice in every blessing you send. Lord, in your mercy. And now we lift up in prayer, from the silence of our hearts, all those personal hopes and concerns that we may have. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And in this time of pandemic, we lift up to you all who suffer, all who mourn, all who worry, all who struggle. We ask for wisdom for all leaders. We pray for strength and stamina for all those who work to bring health and healing, and for those who continue to provide the things necessary for life, especially those who work in our grocery stores and stock the shelves and make sure we have what we need. Lord, in your mercy, we call on your spirit of hope. As you have led the saints in all times and places, stir within us the desire to follow their example, leading us from death to new life in you. Lord, in your mercy, with bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care through Christ our Lord. And gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the one who brought forth Jesus from the dead raise you to new life and fill you with hope, and turn your mourning into dancing. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Christ is risen, just as he said. Go in peace, share the good news. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.